Even a couple of women with cauldrons, maybe. Now that's my favourite. A woman and a cauldron. Now that's an image you can hang a tale on. When you see a woman with a cauldron, you could be any old woman with her auntie or your friend stirring the pot. And women have been stirring the pot since time began. You're throwing in something here and there, taking something and making something completely different. They've been making that stew since time began, or even before, if you believe some of those old stories. But the woman in this story, it's not your auntie, it's not your mammy, it's Cerridwen. She's the one. She's making a secret recipe. It's whispered only in the dark. A potent stew. She's the one who ate the apples of immortality at the beginning of the world. And she lives backwards and forwards, and then backwards again. She's old now, but maybe in the spring she'll be young again. But now she's the caviar, the hag, and she's making a potion for her son, Affective. The ugliest man in the world. And the name don't help. Affligan uttered darkness. But a mother loves all her children, and she would see them do well in the world. And she conceived the notion that if Affligan had some drops of ointment, the grace and inspiration that created the entire universe, he would have such wit and wisdom, his ugliness would be entirely overlooked. So here she is, bent over her stew pot, her belly hanging over that other stew pot that she always has there. But the problem with this recipe is that the potion has to brew for a year and a day in order to reach its full potency. Now, a year and a day, that's a long stretch of time. And however much a woman might love her pug ugly son, she's got to be about her business. She's got to be creeping through the forest and the back alleys, searching out bits and bones and things that are lost, looking for, you know, herbs, you know, picking them according to the phases of the moon and all this stuff. But if she's going to be doing this, she's got to find somebody to watch her pot. So she finds a boy, Gwynbach. Now, folks say there's no Gwynbach, but there he is. Boy! This boy, firmly baked and wet behind the ears. And Cerridwen gives him explicit instruction. No dipping in the pot. I know, boys, if there's one drop missing, I'll take the skin of your back off over your head. You understand me?
Uh-huh.
And don't let that pot boil over. Don't let it get too hot and you keep it stirring. Do you understand?
Uh-huh.
So then she's off. And Gwyn's there stirring the pot. And his mind begins to wander. And he's just thinking and not watching what he's doing. And the pot begins to boil. And it's doing it, it's so hot that water is roiling and boiling and steaming up. And a drop of that boiling water just pops right out of that stew pot and lands on Gwyn's thumb. Ow! And it sticks that thumb in his mouth. And all of a sudden, the lights come on. Because this isn't just any old stew. This is the grace of inspiration. Knowledge of all the past and all the future. Suddenly, Gwynbach knows things. And he's not quite sure what to do with all this knowledge. But one thing that he's sure of is that when Cerridwen finds out, she is going to be furious with him. And he can imagine now. Oh, he can imagine all the things that she's going to do to him. So he runs away, leaving the pot untended, and it continues to boil and boil until it gets so hot it bursts. And all the grace of inspiration runs out, flooding onto the floor, running out of the door, into the swale, into the rivers, like an industrial spell. Well, when Cerridwen comes back, and she finds the work of an entire year ruined, she is cursing that runty little stew spoiler, Gwen, back! Another Cerridwen, she may be old, but her eyes are as sharp as a scythe, and she's doing it.
Shining from his forehead is almost blinding.
Behold, a radiant